This is the SAP Developer News for September 11th, 2025.
In case you missed it, the August 2025 release of CAP has landed with myriad updates. Now, this is going to be a slightly longer news item than usual, so grab a cup of tea and settle in. So, front and center for us all is the brand new CAPI organization on GitHub, which contains a reorganized set of repos, including individual sample repos, plus the CAPI documentation source repo itself, where contributions are welcome. Along with this reorganization comes continuous content deployments and a setup of package publication, which is great, not least for package reuse. And this CAPI organization is also the new home for discussions all around CAP. Check it out. So now, in the new and recently GA, generally available topic, we can see that the previously beta-only support for persistent Fury draft messages has now graduated and become GA. Also, there's a new MCP server for CAP that can provide AI-powered development help. Talking of GA, in the language and compiler topic, you may remember the introduction of support for expressions as first-class annotation values. Well, that support is also now GA. Staying in the language and compiler topic, the query compiler has a new optimization for path expressions involving managed to-one associations. A foreign key path expression is now translated to the local foreign key column instead of the joined remote one. In the Node.js runtime, this is now default, and you can turn it on with a switch in the Java runtime. Now, in a related update, you can now collapse foreign key path expressions for managed to one associations into something simpler and let auto coercion resolve this view into the more specific single foreign key specification, like this example shown in a where clause. Now, moving to the Node.js and Java runtimes, there are plenty of updates too. Let's start with Node.js. There's a feature that was first introduced in the Java runtime back in April this year. This is also now being made available in Node.js. It's how elements that are annotated with common.text are automatically included when a $search request is processed. Great stuff. There's also now a new database service level feature that allows you to stream query results direct from the persistence layer to the HTTP response, bypassing any need to materialize the result set in memory. There are also new features relating to requiring and connecting to remote services, a new utility method for working with linked definitions, and a new container for authentication-related information, and that's cdsuser.authinfo. This replaces the now deprecated cdsuser.tokeninfo. Moving to the Java runtime, there are quality of dev life improvements when working with query results. For typed queries, the results are automatically typed, and you don't need to provide the accessor interface anymore if you're using the single list of or stream of methods. Now, for single tenant applications, this is staying in the Java runtime right now, the feature attachment plugin now supports, in an alpha version, the SAP BTP object store. And now you'll need a service binding to an object store backend, AWS's S3, Azure's blob storage, and Google's cloud storage are all supported. Now, you may already know of CDS Generate, part of the CDS Maven plugin, which automatically generates access interfaces for all structured CDS model types. This feature has been evolving, and the team recommends you do use this as it brings benefits that in turn allow better compile time checking. Now, there's lots of detailed documentation on this just waiting for your reading pleasure in CAPI, so go and check it out. Last but not least, there's now a convenience URL that you can directly select from the console log output, and it'll take you directly to the server's index page. Nice. Moving on to the tools area, the CDS plugin for IntelliJ is now at 2.0.0 and is now fully compatible with the free community edition of IntelliJ, which means that anyone and everyone can use IntelliJ for CAP development. The new 2.0.0 version brings lots of IDE features, lots of new features for the IDE, enhanced LSP integration, and new options in the settings page. And there are also, in the tools topic, new ESLint checks for JavaScript, making your life as a developer easier and the life of your code smoother. There are 5 safety checks so far. Take a look in the CDS Lint section of CAPIA. And last but certainly not least, in this release, there's been some awesome work in the area of GitHub Actions. A new guide, sample workflows, and lots more to help you manage, test, deploy, package, and release your CAP projects. Now that is cool. All this and more in the August 2025 release section of the CAPIA documentation. Thanks, CAP team.
Big news for ABAP developers. ABAP AI just keeps growing. Back in February, we announced that Jules speaks ABAP. Since then, there has been a wave of new AI-driven skills. Now, you can generate wrapped business objects from the database table all the way to the UI service. You can create unit tests, explain code, complete code directly in the editor, and even implement validation and determination. These capabilities are already live in the SAP BTP ABAP environment and SAP S/4HANA Cloud Public Edition. And they're coming to S/4HANA Cloud Private Edition in the 2025 release. Even better, ABAP AI remains free of charge. The free promotions we introduced earlier this year have been extended until further notice. And here's another big step forward. ABAP AI will also become available for older S/4HANA private releases. Think of an AI service running side by side with your ABAP instance. That means you can benefit from the latest innovations without waiting for an upgrade. Want the full details? You can stay tuned for TechEd 2025. And if you want to read more on these release updates, the link is in the description below.
SAP Business Data Cloud, or BDC, brings a data product-centric approach to managing business data. Each data product is a curated, semantically enriched package of business process data, harmonized and replicated from systems like SAP S/4HANA. For solution developers and architects among you, BDC offers a standardized platform to build, extend, and consume these data products, exposing them through APIs or events for integration with both SAP and third-party applications. To dive deeper, check out the SAP Business Data Cloud blog series, including the latest post on customer-managed data products. You'll see how to build a custom data product in SAP S/4HANA Cloud Private Edition using a custom CDS entity. There is also a dedicated series that walks through consuming data products in SAP Databricks for machine learning workflows and exposing them for inference. You'll find links to all these resources in the description. And as Devtoberfest approaches, be sure to catch the sessions featuring product managers and the CTO of SAP Business Data Cloud.
SAP TechEd 2025 Berlin has just released the Agenda Builder, so you can now set your schedule for the event. Just scroll through all of the sessions. 250 keynotes, hands-on workshops, community talks, strategy talks, roadmaps, and more. Select the ones that you like, click Add to Schedule, and you're set to go. They are added to your dashboard. What's really great is that the sessions you wouldn't dream of missing are already in your schedule, like Key 101, the developer keynote, run by a bunch of developer advocates you may recognize. If you're in Berlin, please drop by and say hello. If you can't make it to Berlin, you can still create an agenda for SAP TechEd Virtual. And the same Key 101 developer keynote will be automatically added to your schedule. I love playing with the theme.
Howdy, y'all. Everyone's favorite fall tech fest is just about to start. Devtoberfest 2025 kicks off on September 29th, which is only a few weeks away. Each day spotlights a different theme: ABAP, front-end, tooling, AI, and more. As in years past, it's free and fully online, so jump in, earn points on the scoreboard, chase Nirvana, and put yourself in the running for the grand prize, which this year is a retreat to a future TechEd event, and meet us developer advocates in person. Check out the post linked below for more info on the great sessions we've got coming up and the contest to see how you can win that fantastic grand prize. We hope you're just as excited to participate as we are to go live. And as always, happy coding.